I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
The School of Penny for Patient fundraiser begins next week. Our goal is to raise $1,000.
Black History Month ends with one of the most influential people in the history of humans, Martin Luther King Jr.
I have a dream that one day this nation will rise up, live out the true meaning of its creed. We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal.
Martin Luther King Jr. was born on January 15, 1929, and graduated as the valedictorian of Crozier Theological Seminary in 1951. King became pastor of a Baptist church in Montgomery, Alabama, and later completed his PhD.
Martin Luther King was a religious man. He was a pastor and looked at racism and all of the so-called separate but equal laws and the terrible treatment of people of color in the United States. And he said, this is absolutely wrong. This is against God's will. This is not recognizing the dignity of peoples. And he made us all face that in very powerful ways.
On the eve of Rosa Parks' refusal to move to the back of a city bus in 1955, King was chosen to lead a citywide bus boycott. 2 years later, King and a group of civil rights activists formed the Southern Christian Leadership Conference to conduct nonviolent protests for civil rights.
When Martin Luther King led the Alabama boycott, that was a major turning point in the fight for civil rights. What you saw was people who had been fractionized coming together as one, walking together with others joining the fight. This was when people, America, the world, stood up and said, whoa, what are we looking at here? An amazing time.
Inspired by Gandhi's activism, King worked with the SCLC to organize black voters and civil rights protests. In 1963, King was arrested at a march in Alabama. During his prison time, King wrote a rebuttal to an article denouncing his methods. His longhand notes on the margins of the newspaper became known as Letter from Birmingham Jail and was famously republished and studied in colleges across the country.
Martin Luther King was a man of God who believed that that calling necessitated social change in the present, and he put his life on the line for that calling.
Free at last! Free at last! Thank God Almighty! We are free at last!
On August 28, 1963, King led more than 20,000 people in a massive demonstration at the Lincoln Memorial, where his speech, I Have a Dream, became a defining moment in civil rights history. Through his work, King helped pass the Civil Rights Act of 1964 and received the Nobel Peace Prize that same year.
Martin Luther King, according to Time in 1963, personified the civil rights movement. He took on one of the greatest challenges of his time and was one of the people that most influenced this very transformative time in American history.
Although King faced criticism from more militant black leaders, he continued his peaceful efforts toward both racial and economic justice. After delivering his I've Been to the Mountaintop speech at a rally in Memphis, King was assassinated the next day on April 4th, 1968, while standing at the balcony of his motel room.
King's assassination was, I think, devastating for many people. But there is also a rising level of organization, and many people, King's assassination galvanizes them into many kind of black power movements across the country, many anti-poverty movements. So it's both a moment of despair, but also a moment of political flowering.
Posthumously, King was awarded the Presidential Medal of Freedom in 1977 and a Congressional Gold Medal in 2004. Today, the Martin Luther King Jr. National Holiday continues to be honored on the third Monday of every January.
Next week on March 6th, White Oaks Visual and Performing Arts Department having a fundraising concert. 7th and 8th grade combined chorus and dance department will be performing. The concert is raising money for Every Mind. Every Mind is a nonprofit organization that provides free mental health, education, and counseling services to Montgomery County. Admission will be $1 at the door, and there's also a donation box if anyone wants to contribute more. All proceeds will go to helping Every Mind and their important services to our community.
Welcome to the fun drive.
I know, right? I mean, I'm serious. How did she avoid a lawsuit?
I mean,
she took them everywhere.
How did she keep her license? I mean, she was a dangerous driver.
Welcome to the fun drive. Dear teachers, we'll collect items. Every time an item are brought or collected in your name, we'll be placed into a raffle for $25 gift cards, which include GameStop, Chipotle, Marshalls, and other gift cards. The more items you bring, the better your chances are winning. Students will come around during the year to collect items and raffle tickets. The drawing will be held in May. Good luck.
These are some of the items you should be looking around your house to get ready to bring in.